Hi, I'm Dr. Rajasekhar M R from Chirag Global Hospitals, BTM second stage, Bangalore. Let us know the role of probiotics. Now that is one of the things which is making waves in medical gastroenterology. Probiotics. So there are, we have got gut bacteria which are helpful for us. All the bacteria are not harmful. In fact, most of the bacteria are helpful. Without them, we cannot survive. If you are living happily and having a good life, healthy life, it is because of the both intestinal helpful bacteria, and there are millions of bacteria on the skin which are doing that job, cleaning and maintaining the health of the skin, health of the intestines. So they are very, very useful. So when we are using too much of antibiotics, so many other drugs we are using, they can disturb this bacterial milieu, bacterial pattern, which are there in the intestines. This is very, very important, and now we know the importance of this. So probiotics and prebiotics are used. So we use certain bacteria which are the spores of the bacteria in a capsule form or in a sachet form, we'll be giving them. So the spores will develop into helpful bacteria. There is a lot of research going on in this, and certain bacteria which are useful, the combination of those bacteria are used to make the intestinal content, again intestinal flora we call it as, intestinal flora, normal flora, better. So in both IBS and IBD, these have been tried and it is giving good results. In fact, now we are using even faecal transplant. There is something called faecal transplant. A normal person's feces we collect, we process it and then put it into the large intestine. So that is giving very good results both in IBD and probably in IBS. We have not tried in IBS. So these are all the, some are the new dimensions of treatment in IBS and IBD. Is there any difference in the treatment of IBS and IBD? Yes. IBS is a disease which is more or less a symptomatic disease, which has got more symptoms, and then we can treat it symptomatically, and also we can treat it by lifestyle changes and food, all those things. Whereas IBD is a disease, proper disease, which has to be treated with the medicines. So IBD, we usually use some anti-inflammatory agents, local anti-inflammatory agents, some tablets or what we call as suppositories from anal canal we introduce. So that will help in the reducing the inflammation. And then there are some suppressing the inflammation using immunomodulators. So the injectable forms are available, oral forms are available. They are all the new medicines which will improve the IBD. Steroids, when it is in acute phase, when it is causing lot of trouble, when the disease is very severe and serious, that time we use even steroids to suppress the inflammation there. So IBD treatment is totally different. Some of them in IBD, in ulcerative colitis, there is something called pancolitis, where it is affecting whole large intestine and patient is suffering a lot. So then we'll totally remove the whole large intestine. So they will get rid of the disease. It is cured of the disease. So these are all different approaches for treating the IBD. Whereas in IBS, there is no surgery. There is no medical treatment per se, except for changing the lifestyle and a symptomatic treatment. If there is diarrhea, give tablets to reduce the bowel movements. If there is pain, we will give some sort of antispasmodics. Or if the bowel movement is weak, we then will give some what we call as prokinetics, which will improve the bowel movement. So these are the totally different diseases, totally different sort of treatment.